Hey guys, it's Dani, and yes, I'm still very, very sick, as you can hear, but if you can believe it, I'm better than 2 days ago or yesterday, even though you can obviously tell. So please excuse my voice, I just need to start working again because I need to. So today we're gonna discuss, as promised, about how I managed to lose all of my telomeres. And not only, sadly, today will not be necessarily a very fun or funny video in that respect because, yeah, it's not good to see absolutely damaged orchids that cannot be recuperated anymore because, yeah, that's what I have. But these are part of the hobby as well. They will happen when you least expect sometimes, and no matter how experienced you are, from time to time you might have one of these bad luck situations happening, and it's good to know, I believe, what to expect. But it's totally fine if you don't want to see really bad looking orchids today. Maybe today is not your day. So if you want to skip this video or watch it some other time, that's absolutely fine. I just had to warn you that I will show you some orchids which are unsavable. But hey, what to do? Such is life, things happen. And today we're gonna see what can happen when you can follow the rules, follow the advice, and still have bad results, simply because that's the nature of things. So let's get on with the orchid video. Okay, so you might already know this, but for those of you who don't know, for about a month, maybe a little more than a month, month and a half, I've been playing around with the orchids outside on my terrace. I currently have my cattleyas, epidendrums, phalaenopsis type dendrobiums, and all of these hot growers. I have them outside in an Easter location, and they're okay. They're doing okay. I need to water them a lot more than I expected, but still, they're okay. I'm not gonna go into that situation because that will be for a different video. So I placed the Vandas there as well, and they were okay, they were doing okay, but for Vandas, I do need more light than this, and I always wondered if I could do something about placing them on the western or southern location. So I played around with some locations, I tried to give them sunlight until 10 o'clock or something, and it didn't end well. I had a few burns here and there, so I decided, okay, I need to shade them somehow with something. Need to create a shading space, a shade tent, something of the sorts. Oh, mind you, the cattleyas get sun from whenever it rises until 8 o'clock in the morning. Afterwards, it's just kind of bright light, but no sunshine. Not sure if it's good for cattleyas either, that's why I'm having second thoughts. But definitely for Vandas, it wasn't all that great. I mean, 2 hours of direct sunshine and then just bright shade. In the greenhouse, actually, it's better because I have my southern exposure there and I have multiple hours of sunshine filter through the curtain, right? So I played around with moving them around for about a month. At some point, they got inside. I filmed that and then I put them back outside in a different location. I just played around with them for about a month and a half or so. Time in which, of course, they experience direct sunshine in the morning and then the very hot temperatures and all of that. You'd think they got adjusted to it. And, well, they kind of did, but I'll talk about the Vandas after I talk about the telumnias. The telumnias were outside as well, but they were together with the Vandas. They were receiving that direct sunshine in the morning, 2 hours, and then that was it. And I thought, you know what, okay, I have the telumnias outside for a month already, a month and a half. They're acquainted with the temperature as well. And if you remember in the greenhouse, I had them hanging together with the Vandas. I thought, you know what, okay, I'm gonna put them with the Vandas, wherever I put the Vanda. And so what I did was I bought shading cloth and a tomato cage. This is actually it, because my terrace is not like a garden. I cannot really put stuff on the terrace. It is a covered terrace. I don't have sun from above necessarily, so it's not like mounting a tent and that's it. Either I cover an entire face of the terrace, which was pretty much out of the question, either I improvise a shade tent. So I got this tomato cage, I put the shade cloth instead of its plastic wrapping, if you know those plastic things, and voila, presto, I had bars to hang my Vandas. I bought two of them, one is still outside, and the shade cloth I bought was 95%. This is what we use here. So I thought, well, alrighty then, let's give it a test, let's give it a go. So in the first day, I placed the Vandas. under this. And at the end of the day, I came to see the damage, and I did actually post a picture on one of the Vanda leaves. You could actually see the circles where the sun managed to get or poke through the shading cloth. And this happened on the Vandas which were closer to the shade cloth. And then, you know, I remembered, oh wait, there's a principle in physics, I think, where when light actually passes through a hole, it's more intense and more concentrated closer to the hole. And then the further away you go, it gets more diffused. It has to do with light being a wave and then the dispersion. I'm not gonna get into it because I'm really not good at physics. But obviously, you can Google it. And anyway, this Vanda was actually touching with one of her leaves, the shade cloth. So I thought, alrighty then, no more touching shade cloths. We're gonna have to go further away from the shade cloth. And so we did. That was the first day. The second day, everything looked okay. Oh, especially in the second bar, everything looked okay. Nothing was burned. So I thought, okay, they're safe now, further away from the shade cloth. I'm just going to put there my telumnias as well. Because, you know, if these Vanda seedlings made it, except that one, that was actually closer. Anyway, so if these Vanda seedlings made it, the telumnias should make it as well. Well, guess again. So I placed my telumnias there for a day, and let me show you the result after 6 hours of this filtered sunshine. And here are my telumnias. It has been a few days, and many leaves have fallen. They're absolutely scorched, all of them. Maybe I can salvage something from this one. I'm currently trying to save something, but yeah, it's just, look at this. And this happened in about 6 hours of the telumnias being already acclimated with the outside world, just not living under a shade cloth for 6 hours, apparently. And yeah, when I filmed this, I started to cry because I just realized, you know what, you just destroyed all of your telumnias that you had for a few years. Not only that, you actually received a telumnia, this one, which I'm hoping, I don't know if I can save it. So you destroyed all of them in a matter of 6 hours. How is this even possible? How does this even happen? Well, it happens when you don't really account for something. So you know how the Arctic, and including myself, I always tell you, do things gradually. I think, I'm not sure, maybe I was the first one to tell you what actually happens during the heat stress and so on. Check it down below, it's actually a very informational video. So I do try to follow all of this advice that I preach as well for so long, of acclimating orchids, of making sure you don't just take it from a shady situation and put it in a bright hot situation. Yes, I do know all of these things. I make videos about all of these things, and they do work for the main part. They just don't work when you're dealing with something as extreme as Cyprus weather, apparently. 1 month of acclimating to the heat and the morning sun at least, not enough. And they're telumnias. They're supposed to be worm growers, and they're supposed to like bright light. And I'm afraid that somebody who doesn't live as close to the equator as me, I don't think you guys would understand exactly how intense the situation is. I'm coming from a temperate climate myself, and every year there are stuff to make me say, oh my god, the sun here is just unbelievable. And I'm guessing it can get even worse the closer you get to the equator. Now there is of course a physical explanation for it. It has to do with the angle of the sun rays. We get that. Everything on paper we know. But when it comes to the actual practice, I mean, 1 month of being in the heat and in morning sun did not prepare these orchids at all for spending 6 hours under a shade cloth. With sun, yeah, but under a 95% shade cloth. And thus, I destroyed all of my telumnias in one single day. All of these years of caring for them, and if you remember, they were actually looking great. I put them in those little baskets, they were doing good. Everything gone in 6 hours. Yeah, it happened. So, take away something very important. Follow the articles, follow my advice, but do things even more gradual than this, because what the articles don't tell you is how long this transition period should be. I thought a month is more than enough. It's okay. Every day, exposed to the heat, to the morning sun, these orchids should have been prepared, they were not. So in the end, either your location simply cannot support these orchids no matter what, simply because they reached their limit, or if you're gonna expose something and get it adjusted to the outside world, if you know you're in a very hot and tropical location, starting February, try to acclimate them, because if you try to do it in a month, month and a half, you might actually end up like this, where everything is just scorched and yeah, I cannot even save these. What happens is the tissue is destroyed and inside it gets infected because it is destroyed and starts to break down. So there's nothing I can do because there's just so much tissue that is starting to break down. If I remove it completely, I end up with nothing. This one might actually be savable. This is the corona, but I'm not sure. Everything else is just absolutely not savable. Of course, I'm gonna keep them until they're very, very dry because we still have the rhizome, we still have the roots. But yeah, there's really no chance of these guys ever bouncing back. So yeah, it looks bad, and take it into account that all the work you put into an orchid can actually be taken away just like that, just because you thought, hey, this should work. Theoretically, it should work. On paper, it should work. No, if this were Romania, yeah, it might have worked. But this is not Romania, this is Cyprus, and things are unforgiving here. But the Tulumnias are not the only ones that I messed up with. Let's look again at the Vandas. Now, the vast majority of the Vandas are perfectly fine. Even the Rhynchorhynchus Bangkok Sunset, which I almost burned 2 years ago, she's okay, or he's okay, he's here. He was actually on the second bar along with the Tulumnias. And let me give you a close-up. He's okay. He did not get burned. So as I was saying, my older Vandas are pretty much okay, except a few small burns here and there, which I showed you either on the picture or on the video, there you go. These ones were the places where the leaves actually touched. This was made a longer time ago in the other location. The other one was made in the close proximity of the shade cloth, but that's it. There's nothing really dramatic going on with them. And yeah, they have been a month outside. Also, these are my older Vandas. They spent a lot of time in my southern location. But I have a few new Vandas that I added to the collection a month ago, 2 months ago, something of the sorts. Needless to say, those Vandas, they don't look so good. Let me show you. This is the Gigantea spots that I purchased from Orchids Deluxe a couple of months ago. And this was the side that was exposed to the shade cloth. It was on the second line. And there we have it, all of that brown stuff, it's sunburn, all of the stuff on the leaves, again, sunburn. This side is not sunburn, but this side is enough. I think the leaves will be compromised. I think everything will fall, and I'm not sure if I can save this orchid. I'm hanging on to it, but again, I do believe that I'm going to lose this orchid. And this happened, I didn't even see it happening. Couple of days, that's how long they spent under the shade cloth. And I drew the conclusion that, you know what, my older Vandas being exposed for 1 year or 2 years to the sunshine in the southern location in the grow space were acclimated more to this light than the new Vandas, even though, you know, I did not anticipate that. But I guess 1 year is better than being acclimated for 1 month. So this is one that I purchased, but even sadder than this, let me show you another one. This is the Vanda Virafando that I actually received, and everything here used to be nice looking leaves. They all fell. When I picked up this orchid, they just all fell. This is what's left of her. Everything is scorched, everything is burned. I don't really remember if this was in the front line or the second one. It doesn't really matter because yet again, this was a new orchid and it just could not cope. Even though acclimated for a month or a little bit more than a month or something like that in the eastern exposure location. Under the shade cloth, it did not do great. And I placed the Vandas in a southern western location, so they had sunshine from 2 o'clock in the afternoon until the sun went down. It was pretty much the hottest part of the day, but I thought, you know what? It is ventilated, it's breezy, I live on an island, it's shade cloth, air circulates through the shade cloth, and it's 95%. I even took a picture to see the difference between a proper sun location and the shade cloth. It's pretty shady. If I put another shade cloth on it, it would just be shade. I might as well just put the Vanda somewhere where it's shady. It's exactly like that. And behold, these are the two Vandas which I believe I will lose. Other than that, everything else is pretty okay. I don't have many sunburns, not even with the Rinkoritas Bangkok Sunset, which made a video about it. She doesn't like strong light. So if that one didn't get burned, and these ones did, there's a very big conclusion to be drawn here. 1 year, 2 years of acclimating something does not compare to 1 month or 2 months. And I think that if I do want to grow Vandas outside, which I'm seriously thinking of not even trying anymore, I would have to start at least from February. Whenever spring comes, January, February, I will start to bring my Vandas outside and get them adjusted, because I just don't believe I can do it in May, June, when already things are so incredibly hot. I think you can understand now why I just couldn't film this video on Saturday and why I was just so emotional. And so, yeah, it's not okay. It's not something to be proud of, but at least, you know, make something educational out of it. So bottom line, if you didn't know that orchids needed to be acclimated to certain light exposures, check the video down below. Yes, they do need to be acclimated, slowly adjusted. And in my video, I explain what's actually happening, what is the actual substance that protects them from the heat stress and why it needs time to build up. But I never told you how much time. Did any article ever told you how much time or this period of time, what it depends on? Because I don't think anybody ever did. If the articles would specify acclimate them for a year before you actually move them, you know, I would have done it, but I think nobody actually knows. And I'm thinking that if my climate would have been the Romanian climate, it wouldn't have ended up like this. But I live in Cyprus, where it's very close to the equator. Well, not very close, but closer than Romania is, where sun is more unforgiving. And yeah, coming from that climate to this climate, I'm always surprised. So there we have it. I told you this was not a happy video, but I hope you learned something and you will keep in mind something. At least when you want to acclimate something outside, keep in mind your climate. If you're in a temperate climate, things will go a lot smoother, I suppose. The closer you go to the equator, the harder and more unforgiving the climate becomes, and at some point maybe we have to come to the conclusion that some stuff are really just not suited for the climate. Those couple of hot months, maybe they're not suited for orchids outside, even though year-round they might be. But hey, my experience should not be your experience. Just take it as what could happen and just be careful. And as a last question, for those of you who live very close to the equator, such as me, maybe South Florida, maybe you guys in Mexico, in Central America, maybe in the Arabian countries, if you're watching, how do you grow orchids outside, or do you grow orchids outside? Do you actually acclimate them for a year? I saw on the internet Vandas grown outside in Jamaica, and I'm thinking, well, why can't I do it? After a month and a half of acclimating, still not happening. Yeah, and even though my Vandas responded okay, don't have sunburns, I didn't want to risk it because their leaves were just getting so hot. And after I saw what happened and I saw that even my older Vandas, if they're too close to the shade cloth, they can get burned, I just freaked out and I decided to bring everybody in, and that is that. So maybe I shouldn't give up. I thought I had it under control, but I didn't. Maybe next year I'll try again and start adjusting them from February. I don't know. Some thoughts from you guys who live in climates such as mine would be appreciated. I think it's time to end now. I'm gonna go medicate myself, and fingers crossed that I'll have a better voice tomorrow. Thank you guys for watching. This is the story of how I destroyed all of my Telumnias, two of my Vandas. And hopefully that's it. At least the Cattleyas are doing okay. And I hope you take something good and educational away from this video. And with that said, thank you for watching. You know the drill, give this video a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Subscribe to my channel for regular orchid videos, tutorials, and sometimes, you know, what not to do. And if you like YouTube to notify you whenever I upload a new video, just turn on notifications for my channel. And yeah, see you guys tomorrow. Bye.